मोस्ट वेलकम सर, शैल आई स्टार्ट सर? ओके, कोरोना वायरस हैज लॉक्ड डाउन अप्रोक्सीमेटली 4 बिलियन पीपल इन द वर्ल्ड. इट इज ऑब्वियस दैट द वायरस सीरियसली पोजेस द ग्लोबल थ्रेट एंड ड्राइव्स द पीपल टू सर्वाइव विद फियर. दिस फियर कॉल्ड केओस अमंग सेवरल एरियाज, द पुअर, द इकोनॉमी, मेंटल हेल्थ ऑफ द ब्रेड अर्नर्स ऑफ फैमिली एंड फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन अफेक्टेड सेवरली एंड मेनी डिमांड्स वेयर नाउ सप्लाइड due to contagiousness, we are not supplied. We teaching learning community too, in various ways, are going through immense stress. We are witnessing to the migrants crisis owing to pandemic. Their lives and hopes are shattered. The current pandemic is not just a medical tragedy. Even when the medical threat will disappear, such at least say people across the globe will battle psychological scars for years. In such times of acute crisis, what would be the role of literature? In past pandemics and epidemics, how literature helped to keep humans and humanity intact? How literature decreases our sense of isolation? How it deepens, widens, and expands our sense of life? How it feeds our soul? To discuss all these issues today, we have two renowned academicians with us, and I have pleasure to introduce both of them. Honorable Professor Dr. N.D.R. Chandra, and Professor Dr. M. Manirudhusam. I welcome both of you, sir. Professor Dr. N.D.R. Chandra is a former Vice Chancellor of Bastar University, Jagdalpur, Chhattisgarh. Before that, he worked as in-charge Vice Chancellor and Pro-Vice Chancellors at Nagaland Central University, Kohim, and UGC Visiting Professor at Dr. H.S. Gaur University, Sagar. He was elected member of the Governing Council of the Indo-American Center for International Studies and Vice President of All Indian English Teachers Association. He was awarded postdoctoral fellowship by American Studies Research Center and was associated at IAAS Simla. Professor Chandra has authored many books, research papers, and edited anthologies. And at present, he is working as adjunct professor at Sri Mata Vaishnavi Devi University, Katra, J&K, since 2018. I welcome you, sir. Another resource person who is sharing this keynote session, Professor Dr. M. Manirudhusam, is a well-known academician, professor of English at Jahangirnagar University, Bangladesh, and IELTS speaking examiner, IDP, Bangladesh. He obtained MA in English language and PhD in applied linguistics and ELT from the University of Dhaka, completed e-teacher methodology for TESOL at the University of Maryland, BC. He has completed e-teacher education technology course at Iowa State University and attended PWD 2013 at the University of Oregon, USA. He has 25 years teaching and research experience and more than 100 publications, including research papers, translations, book reviews, and books. His core interest includes TESOL methodology, curriculum design, material development, assessment, and testing educational technology, and EL2 teacher education. I welcome both of you, sir. And now I would like to request Professor Dr. N.D.R. Chandra to deliver his keynote speech. Dr. Chandra.
Thank you, Dr. Nevale. It's my pleasure and privilege to deliver this keynote address on the very pertinent topic of today, the role of literature in the time of corona pandemic crisis. In fact, we have great scholars in inaugural sessions, and we have many participants attending this great event, two-day international web conference. I am happy to see Mr. Dinesh from Simla and young scholar Dr. Vikram Dwivedi, whom I know very well. So thanks to the organizing committee and each and everyone who is participating in this event. I'm not techno savvy, and in fact we are taking a lot of time to connect with you. I'm sorry for it. After long time I am participating in such a conference. So it's a great time for me. Dr. Nevale has been instrumental to bring here, and a special thanks goes to him for inviting me. The topic is such, you know, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Chairperson, Professor A.M. Manirudhman is there from Dhaka. Sir, namaskar to you.
Namaskar.
Namaskar, namaskar. I would like to begin my talk with on this topic, the role of literature in the time of Corona pandemic crisis. There has been three important revolutions in the world. The first revolution is agrarian revolution, that people started agriculture and farming, living in the woods. And the second important revolution is industrial revolution. There lies some sort of uncertainties. We have capitalist society and evils of capitalist society. And the third important revolution is information revolution, where we have high-tech computers and so on and so forth. And our young generations throughout the world are much and more engaged in this information revolution. And the fourth I'm adding here is microbial revolution. The microbes, the small living thing, could be good for society and it could be bad for society. The microbes and microorganisms, bacteria and viruses and other germs, which are responsible for spreading diseases and epidemics that led to corona-like epidemic and pandemic crisis. It has today forced us to a kind of a reverse migration and a kind of reverse brain drain. As we know, corona is a microscopic virus, and it looks as if it is covered with pointed structures around them like a corona or crown. It is made of RNA and proteins. It is covered with fat externally. When we wash our hand, this hand with soap, the fat part fall apart. This corona is responsible for transmitting disease from person to person by contact, touch, or droplets that carry viruses. It can infect our mouth, nose, eyes. As use of mask has been prescribed, we need to maintain social distancing of 5 feet. The virus may remain 4 to 10 days in different articles and particles. Next. The symptoms are respiratory problems besides runny nose and sore throat. We need to disinfect through hand wash, hand sanitizer, and a need to wear gloves. We need to bleach the objects. And also, we have to save us from transmission of corona. We need to be isolation. Besides this, we need to enhance our immunity, taking suitable food, herbals and medicines, and also we need to use Arogya Setu. Stay at home is the best prescription today. we should not hate and discriminate the infected quality person, but we must care for him, yet we have to save us intelligently and the causes. Caution is very important. I would like to quote Anderson, Executive Director of United Nations Environment Program, recently said that the coronavirus pandemic and the climate crisis are messages for the nature. It is known that a belief in limitless growth, high consumption lifestyles, and indifference to the climatic change, among other reasons, have destroyed and shifted habitats of wild species, bringing them in close proximity to humans, leading to spillover events and increasing outbreaks of zoonotic diseases like COVID-19. The infection and transmission is more in citified life, and that is why people are leaving the city and returning to the villages and concentrating on agriculture, and perhaps Gandhi and Kutir Udyog of sustainable development could be good for us. One screen, another screen, third screen. We are here.
I think it is not audible. Volume control. No problem. Yeah, people can understand by movement also.
Is it all right?
It's all right. Only voice problem is there, but no problem. Okay. It is, I think, the 1 minute video, no? No problem.
Okay, thank you. This poem, COVID-19, the pandemic 2020 by Dr. Poonam Dwivedi, expresses beautifully the pandemic situation. What we are facing today, in fact, to save us, we are maintaining social and physical distancing, masked faces, sanitizer, washing of hands, home isolation, loneliness, quarantine, diseases, hospitals, suffering and death are common features today. Wherever one looks, be it Twitter, Facebook, WhatsApp, email, newspaper, everywhere there is a Holocaust, a kind of vacuity, a kind of wasteland where there is no life, even we are alive. Life seems to be seized, even the clock is striking, and we are witnessing the rising, shining, and the setting of the sun. We have coronavirus pandemic everywhere. Everything is silent, calm, and quiet. And there is a poem that homeless homes are blooming with fear. The cities are paralyzing in settlements and suburbs, confined everywhere. Human being, the life has become costly again today, and property has become cheaper. Ghar gulzar sune shahar basti basti mein qaid har hasti ho gayi, aaj phir jindagi mahangi ho gayi aur daulat sasti ho gayi. After this we are coming to the next point, that is crisis. Crisis implies a kind of judgment, a kind of decision about critical moment or change. It also refers discrimination and decision. It also signifies the point in progress of disease when an important development or change takes place, which could be decisive or recovery or death. We can visualize the macroscopic and telescopic outlook of the problems of corona pandemic crisis. Some of them are as follows. We have health crisis, loss of human lives, sorrows and sufferings. Health facilities were neglected area in India, but because of corona pandemic and crisis, we are trying to improve our health facilities in India. We have economic crisis. There is a kind of recession and there is economic collapse. Many people lost their jobs, especially in organized sectors. There is unemployment crisis. People are in search of livelihood. And it has been reported by Economic Times that as many as 2.7 crore people, they lost their job, and that affected as many as 14 crore population. Networking marketing could be a solution to the problem of unemployment, but we have a lot of illiterate laborers in India who cannot do this job. We have energy crisis, labor crisis, food crisis, traveling crisis. Because of lockdown, we cannot travel from one place to another. And moreover, there was no flight, no bus, and no train. Recently, they have started to bring stranded laborers from different places. We have religious crisis, that people started questioning the very existence of God. We have crisis in educational sectors, in universities, colleges, and schools. Our youngsters, they cannot attend the college and universities. Hence, we are conducting online classes and exams. but career of the youngsters are at stake today. We have climatic change, is a kind of crisis. There have been cyclones in eastern and western parts of India and loss of human life and property. This is because of high temperature in land and sea. We are also witnessing locust attack in agricultural field in India, Africa, and America. They are destroying the agricultural crops. And lastly, administrative and governance crisis. Henry David Thoreau says that government is the best which governs the least. But the government is becoming more and more authoritarian, and intolerant. I am reminded of the line from P.V. Sally's Ode to the West Wind, where he says, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? Let us be quite hopeful and optimistic that we will survive the great corona crisis and we will come out very well. Next. Now we are coming to the last part of this presentation. The role of literature in the time of corona life pandemic crisis. The age-old role of literature is to instruct and delight. Literature is the record of time. It narrates the past, present, and the future imaginatively. It tells about history, geography, science, philosophy, and everything, and it evaluates everything. It is a literature of power that transports us to different land. In the modern time, literature is a communication and expression of author's experience. The role of literature during corona pandemic is to give comfort and ease. It has to have tranquilizing and soothing effect, calm and quiet, so that we can restructure our life to meet the challenges of the world. Today, it has to decode the complexity of life, as W.B. Yeats says, things fall apart, center cannot hold, mere anarchy is loosed upon the world. Everything is scattered here and there. Anarchy is everywhere. In such a chaotic situation, we are looking for a center, a kind of meaning during corona pandemics. Some of the relevant literatures relating to epidemics and the pandemics surveyed from internet are Homer's Iliad opens with plague. Boccaccio's Decameron sit during the plague death, yet it is harbinger of Renaissance. That people isolate from Florence. And in isolation, they talk about morality, love, sexuality, politics, trade and power to restructure their normal lives, telling stories. Daniel Defoe's Journal of Plague Year, we have another book. Mary Shelley's The Last Man is about a devastating global plague. Edgar Allan Poe's short story, The Mask of the Red Death, causes fatal bleeding from the pores. Albert Camus, The Plague. Stephen King's, The Stand. So, this last work, this shows us how isolation in the days of plague affects us, and how state fails to perform the duty in this panic situation. It also helps us to understand the value of human contact. These writings are about disaster, devastations, and Holocaust. They provide the narrative design that punishes the ill-behaved characters. So further, Ijra Pound poetry is inspired mathematics, while I, Richard, considered it as a music of ideas. The well-known Hindi poet Dinkar is very much, Ramdhari C. Dinkar is very pertinent, very relevant today, as he criticizes the capitalist society. He says, वह मनुष्य मर गया शीश जो है लक्ष्मी का नया जार है गीत उसे क्या जो कुबेर पद पाने का उम्मीदवार है. I would translate it. He passed away. What remained is goddess Abzar. Why to dedicate him a song who has the candidature to give wealth, the wealth? Dinkar was the poet of social revolution, and he envisioned that wealth of capitalists will be snatched by people soon, and then there will be a kind of egalitarian society, he aptly asserted. उसी तरह ये नोट तुम्हारे पापी उड़ जाने वाले हैं तब भी मारा गया माल भी और लोग पाने वाले हैं. Your sinful currency is likely to fly, the labor is killed and also the possessions, and receivers are the common citizens. We have seen in the lanes, streets and roads of Italy, the rich people threw the currencies as they could not save the lives with their wealth. The modernist believed in two worlds, the world of literature and the temporal world. They maintained the superiority of world of literature over the temporal world. Today, in the wake of hyper reality, eco literature and corona pandemics, there is a kind of closeness between world and world. The signifier and signified are coming closer. We have no longer actors on this stage, but we are real men and women doing our job and facing all challenges and hard realities of our life. In the industrial and post-industrial age, there has been too much contacts of the people in the forms of relationships, like shaking of hands, embracing, touching, hugging, physical contacts, and so on. These are the forms of closeness and contacts. The third law of Newton is, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Now there is a time for social and physical distancing, which is a reaction of the action of closeness. To interpret it from Aristotle's angle of catharsis, social relationships are the emotions of proximity, while social distancing are emotions of withdrawal. It is said that cosmic energy works everywhere. We need to maintain equidistance, or a kind of equilibrium, in our life. Lastly, today we are living in the wake of third culture. The East and the West is uniting, which were apart earlier. Secondly, there is a kind of hybridization of science and humanities in the wake of third culture. We need to bank upon three kinds of literature today. Classics. We need to prescribe classics. Shakespeare, Milton, Kalidas, Tulsidas. The characters created by these great writers, they show us human condition and they teach us how to live good life. So we have to learn a lot from them. This second kind of literature is the literature of information and knowledge. the new kind of cyber literature or hyper literature. We learn and we will earn through them engaging with media and networking business, even during the course of lockdown pandemics. And the third is regional literature. Lot of languages are dying and disappear. Especially tribal languages are disappearing. There is a need to create literatures in all regional languages. I am happy to mention here that one of my friends wrote two short stories like Naya Samikaran, New Equations, and Lockdown in Chhattisgarhi, which happens to be my mother tongue. These stories are about human relationship and about relationship between human being and job during the food crisis of lockdown. The combination of all three kinds of literature will make our life happier and better. I'm coming to conclude the whole discussion. A crisis is perhaps necessary for physical, moral, and intellectual and spiritual regeneration and the growth of humanity. If there is life, there is a world. Jaan hai to jahan hai. Hence, we need to restructure our lifestyle, such as physical, mental, psychological, religious, and spiritual understandings. When everything is almost closed due to frequent lockdown, the nature is smiling on human beings who are considered to be superhuman and most powerful species in the world. On the other hand, the living things of land, water, and air are enjoying freedom and autonomy as if they are laughing on misery of human life. We need to enhance our humanity power through literature as the words provide strength to fight the epidemics and the pandemics to the power of psychochemical effects. It provides longevity as we arise to do an unaccomplished job, as we desire to do our unaccomplished action. It releases the stress, literature releases the stress of our mind. We feel calm and quiet and all passion spent. The corona pandemic has proved that might is not right. There is a flaw in capitalist and industrialist society of USA and the Europeans. The role of literature during corona-like pandemic crisis is to unite people. It reads the pulse of society and measures the heartbeats. It has the novel idea of Satyam Shivam Sundaram and Vasudeva Kautumbakam to unite people. The literature of Saint poet Kabi is quite relevant today, whose works we need to redeem as he wished to establish a kind of egalitarian society, doing away all kinds of discriminations. He aptly says about the temporary needs of human life. Pani kera gudguda asman uski jaat dekhat hi chhip jayega jo tara prabhat. Like water bubbles, lives of human beings, in a moment, it will disappear in the morning, in a nutshell. We need to do what is undone now. Through literature, we can enhance our actions and longevity. The corona-like pandemic almost closes the door of the world, yet it opens the door of the world, that is literature. The combination of two words, the world, real world, and the word, that is literature, will embolden us, releasing stresses of war of human mind, a discourse which goes on and on. Hence, literature is a thing of beauty and joy forever, even during pandemic crisis. In a nutshell, literature unites humanity. helps in moving towards an egalitarian society. It fights with inequalities and discriminations. It provides human emotions and feelings. The role of literature provides a way, a path that we should not clash like ignorant armies in the night, but believe in the dictum, as Matthew Arnold says, "A love, let us be true to one another." Thank you so much. I must.
Thank you, Professor Chandra. A wonderful delivery, sir.
Oh, thank you.
When writers make us shake our head with the exactness of their texts and even make us laugh about ourselves or life, our buoyancy is restored. We are given a shot at dancing with, or at least clapping along with, the absurdity of life. Instead of being squashed by it over and over again, it's like singing on a boat during a terrible storm at sea. You can't stop the raging storm, but singing can change the heart and spirit of the people who are together on that ship. Really, literature reduces our stress, keep our moral high in pandemic situation. Wonderful, sir. Wonderful talk. This is what you were intended to say. Once again, thank you for this wonderful delivery.
Thank you.
Now, just some questions, but not some questions and answer I'm accessing. I think no. Yeah. Honorable Chairperson, I think that we should proceed to your turn. Okay.
Okay, thank you very much. Wild spirit.
Yeah, because let me check. They've dropped the questions in chat. No. Okay.
Okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
I would like to request Professor Dr. M. Manirudhzam.
Okay, thank you.
To make your person's comment and preside over the session. Your pronunciation is a tongue twister there. Okay. Yeah. Manirudhzaman, that is
difficult. So no problem.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Please, sir.
Thank you very much.
Share your comments and preside over the session.
Let's start with P.B. Shelley.
Okay, sure.
Wild spirit, which art moving everywhere, destroyer and preserver, here. And now, I would like to refer to the presenter's quotation from P.B. Shelley. If winter comes, can spring be far behind? We, of course, overcome the present crisis, COVID-19 pandemic. As the cases and casualties of COVID-19 increase globally, medical professionals are deeply concerned not just about the virus itself, but also about the increasing anxiety and sheer fear people are experiencing as they try to deal with the pandemic. As people around the globe are asked to self-isolate, practice social distancing, and altogether lead a hermetic life to help flatten the curve of human catastrophe, there is no doubt something in the very texture and disposition of the global village is changing, and changing rapidly. A key question today is how to survive, not just the pandemic itself, but to do so with a healthy and robust constellation of our mental, moral, creative, and critical faculties. I do believe literature can play a significant role here. Boccaccio wrote the Decameron in the wake of the plague outbreak in Florence in 1348, to guide fellow Italians on how to maintain mental well-being in times of pandemics and isolation. The racist stories in the book are allusions to the power of storytelling to maintain robust mental health in a time of overwhelming anxieties. That meant protecting yourself with stories. Pfizer tells us, Boccaccio suggested, you could save yourself by fleeing town, surrounding yourself with pleasant company, and telling amusing stories to keep spirits up. Through a mixture of social isolation and pleasant activities, it was possible to survive the worst days of an epidemic or pandemic. that sounds like a perfect recipe and our tonic these days too. Thank you, Professor Dr. N.D.R. Chandrasar, for your informative, suggestive, thought-provoking, and motivational keynote speech. Many, many congratulations. In general, literature can sustain in times of crises as we are experiencing now. It helps us get deep into the minds and hearts of people, and that is important during a crisis like COVID-19 pandemic, because we see the condition laid bare. We see the character of people and the interaction of all the different societies, forces in society. It's one of the best ways to find help. Good literature helps us understand good human relations. It's valuable through its nuances, its twists and turns, its dilemmas, and its paradoxes. It helps us see more than is otherwise seen and focus on what ultimately matters. We are living in a very different way now. We are recognizing the importance of our relationships, the meaning of our work, and how can some together come together as a global community. This coronavirus pandemic has helped to understand this very significantly. Throughout the course of history, disease outbreaks, pandemics, plagues, and epidemics have ravaged humanity, sometimes challenging the course of history and at times signaling the end of entire civilization. Literature provides us deepest and insightful records of events during crisis times. In such crisis moments, it helps us to spend time with creative thoughts and relieves us from monotony. Pandemic literature in particular helps us to know pandemics in the true sense. Sometimes we come to know about the superstitions and misconceptions about the disease that help us to distinguish the right from the wrong. Besides, pandemic literature holds the history of pandemics generation to generation with the taste and color of literature. Let me mention some writers who created distinct pandemic, epidemic, and plague literature. In Bangladesh, I can mention Johi Raihan, Humayun Ahmed, Selina Hussein, who significantly contributed to the creation of pandemic literature. In India, I remember Rabindranath Tagore, Prem Chand, Suraya Khan Tripathi, Fakir Mohan Sanapati. These are the significant contributors to pandemic or epidemic literature. In Europe, we can mention, as we have already seen in the presenters, in the keynote speech, Homer, Sophocles, Geoffrey Chaucer, Boccaccio, Jack London, Alessandro Manzoni, Daniel Defoe, Mary Shelley, Pasolini, Albert Camus, Henrik Ibsen, they immensely contributed to pandemic or epidemic or plague literature. And if we consider North America, we find Edgar Allan Poe. We also have seen founded in the keynote speech. Allan Poe has contributed significantly to the creation of pandemic literature. However, COVID-19 promises to alter us in strange ways. It's a paradigm shifting event that divides lives and cultures. We'll emerge changed, though how those changes will manifest is far from certain. What ultimately bring people together are positive values such as love and affection and good values. And what usually brings those out is a common enemy, which in this case is the coronavirus. United, we stand. Divided, we fall. That's very obvious today. There are some different roads ahead, but right now it's a unifying time. Thank you all very much. God bless us all. Goodbye.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Welcome.
There is one question. You are the chairperson. If you permit me,
please.
You are Ruchi, Professor Ruchi Tomar. I promoted her on the screen. Let me unmute. Professor Ruchi, make your video.
Hello?
Dr.
Ruchi. It's a video. Okay. Hello.
Professor Ruchi, ask question.
Sir, I would like to know that how far the Western literature able to cope up with the pandemic crisis of today?
Do you want to ask to India, sir, or Professor Munirudzamam? Okay, do you raise?
Sir, the first one, sir, and we...
But sir, I think that technical problem, sir, I think are very unusable. Okay, you talk. He will reply, okay?
Okay. Okay, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Sir, actually, I would like to ask a question that how far the Western literature is able to cope up with the pandemic crisis of today and how it can be solved through literature.
Yeah, who will respond to the question? I request the presenter, keynote speech presenter, to respond to the question. Hello, do you hear me?
Yeah. Over to you. Sir is not being visible here. I don't know where. Dr. NDR Chandra?
Okay.
You may reply, no problem. I think that what Ruchi intended to say, why
okay.
You distinguish between Eastern literature and Western literature. Both literature in general, it is able to inspire us, to motivate us.
Should I respond?
Should I respond? Yes.
Okay. Yes. Actually, literature is a universal phenomenon.
Yep.
Literature is an universal phenomenon.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
So if we study both Eastern and Western literature, we'll find a lot of things very common, okay? So if we, I already mentioned Homer and Sophocles, they are classical writers. In Sophocles' King Oedipus, we find plague caused by some sort of curse. Anyway, and we learn a lot of lessons. Hello? Am I okay?
Yeah, okay.
We learn a lot of lessons from King Oedipus. Number one, if we do something wrong, we have to face some sort of disaster, like the plague Oedipus. Again, we find some literary works which motivate us, which make us alert to such pandemics or epidemics. In this way, especially if we think of the Western literature, we find that Western literature deals with both the negative sides of plagues or epidemics and positive sides of plagues and epidemics. We can be alert to some negative activities which we shouldn't perform because those things can bring catastrophes or disasters or epidemics or pandemics. Again, sometimes we see that literature helps us, motivates us, and literature keeps us lively and face pandemics boldly. I hope the